mystery in order to carry out their evil purposes. But today, that shall cease in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say it will cease in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Are we ready to pray?
Yes.
Are we connecting?
Yes.
I don't want you to be absent-minded today. I don't care how many number of people here. If it's just only one person here, I'll still preach the same message. It is those who are not here, they miss. That is their problem. I don't care. I will not delay the word of God for some certain people. You are here. God destined you to be here because of your reason. And the Lord will deal with every issue that is not pleasant in your life today in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
So don't look at anybody. Oh, whatever, whatever. It is not your business. God knew those who are going to be here today. Because I pray that prayer this morning. Lord, those who are, you have ordained to be a partaker of this blessing, bring them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God has brought you. And so I believe that God has ordained you to be a partaker of this blessing.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
That's why I told you that this year, you cannot afford to be absent-minded. You cannot afford to be, one for today and one for tomorrow. Off and on. The day, the moment you switch off, that may be the day that God wants to visit you. So you better be alert. So, you know, many times the devil will just say, and that could be the day that God wants to do something in your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So don't be discouraged. Amen.
Amen.
Don't be down. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Be steadfast in the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because in a moment, in a twinkle of an eye, it will change your situation forever in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say it will change your situation forever in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I want to share with you a mystery that the Holy Spirit unveiled some years ago. Hallelujah. It's a mystery about the land. The mystery about the land. Brethren, the land is a mysterious entity. A mysterious entity that has the ability to hear and to respond to programmings and decrees. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Is what? The land is a mysterious entity that has the ability to hear and to respond to programming and decrees. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want you to know that the land is a living thing. You may think the land is not a living thing, it's a living thing. And it has the ability to receive commands and respond to instructions. Hallelujah. The land, I want you to understand another thing. The land has the record of all the people who are living upon it. That's another mystery many people don't know. The land has a record of all the people who are living upon it. And it can hear and bear witness between you and God, or between you and another fellow human being. Did you hear what I said? I said the land has a record of all the people who are living upon it, and it can hear and bear witness between you and God, or between you and another fellow human being. Hallelujah. I want you to listen to what God said in Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 19. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 19 said, I call heaven and what? Are we there? Maybe I should wait a minute. Deuteronomy 30:19. Deuteronomy 30:30. Or you want me to say it in our own way? 30. Hallelujah. Maybe that you understand that. Deuteronomy 30:19. So I call heaven and what?
Earth.
To do what?
Today.
Some version says witness. King James Version says, to record. To record. Hallelujah. So the earth can record. Hallelujah. That's what I just want to bring out of that. I call heaven and earth to record this day. It will not be against you, but it will be in your favor in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say it will be in your favor in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
What I want to bring out there is that the earth can record. Hallelujah. The land can make records concerning every individual. Hallelujah. Those who do evil and believe that no one sees them What they fail to know is that the land is taking records of all that they are doing upon it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The land can be programmed to affect a person's destiny either positively or negatively. I want you to know that whatever the program is what will manifest physically in the life of such person. As long as that person dwells and walks upon the land, unless, of course, it is deprogrammed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the only way you can deprogram it is through the power of prayers. Hallelujah. Any negative program that has been programmed against you into the land, the blood of Jesus will delete it today. The name of Jesus.
Yes.
These wicked people, they know, because they know that the earth is bearing record. They know that you are walking upon the earth. Hallelujah. So they can decree something. I remember when we were still in Brother Michael's place, when we do Monday intercessory prayer. I mentioned something, maybe, I don't know, maybe you still remember. They can gather, you know, you go to a place, you walk, you know, and after you are gone, they just gather the sand where you march. They gather it, and that's it. They can use it to do anything. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Wicked powers. Because you step in it, there's a record already that you have come to that place. Hallelujah. But whatever that might have been programmed against your life into the earth, today, the power of the Most High God is going to delete it in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
I said the blood of Jesus is going to cancel it in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
I said the children of darkness are more knowledgeable than the children of light. And they use this knowledge to afflict other people. I pray that today God will open our eyes of understanding.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
See, the land can receive a negative programming against the life of a person. And not only the person, even the seed after him, his offspring, generation after him. Let's look at an example in Jeremiah 22. Jeremiah 22. Hallelujah. Jeremiah chapter 22. We are reading verse 29 and 30. Jeremiah 22. Verse 29 and 30. Jeremiah 22. Verse 29 and 30. Are we there?
Yeah.
It said, oh, earth. How many times?
Three times.
Why do you think that the Bible mentioned this thing three times? Because the earth can hear. Hallelujah. Oh, earth, hear! Did you see that? Is it in your Bible?
Yes.
Hear the word of the Lord. Thus said the Lord, write ye this man, childless, without fruit, without harvest, without any offspring, a man that shall not prosper in his days. Look at that programming. For no man of his seed shall prosper, not only him, even generation after him, sitting upon the throne of David and ruling anymore in Judah. That was what was programmed into the life of a man called Coniah. Hallelujah. This is to let you know that the land can hear and it can be programmed. Hallelujah. King Coniah of Judah was a descendant of King David. But because he did wickedly before the Lord, the Lord spoke to the land to program evil against him. And not only him, even against his offspring. Verse 30 spell out the evil that was programmed against him. Number one, say, program this man childless. All his children will die before him. Hallelujah. The second one, he said, a man that shall not prosper in his days. Did you see that? They can program poverty into the land for someone. They can program barrenness into the land for someone. This man was, you know, it was programmed into the in the land or on the earth to be poor for the rest of his life. Failure, poverty, tragedy, all forms of calamity was programmed against this man. Not only that, none of his children would succeed him on the throne. Hallelujah. And that means that his line will be completely cut off from the land of the living. I pray this will not happen to you in the name of Jesus. Yeah. I'm ready. If anyone has this kind of, you know, negative programming in the land against him, like this King Coniah, such a person can never amount to anything. No matter how hard a person may try. The only thing that can change this negative program is effective prayer and issuing of command by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Only the power of the Holy Spirit can change.